They claim to have discovered the secrets of Suleiman. What secrets of Suleiman? How he controlled the jinn and the animals. We all should know, those of us that have studied a little bit of Islam, that Suleiman was given something that nobody else was given. We know this? Suleiman was given something that no other prophet was given, no other person was given. And that's what the dua he made to Allah. Oh Allah, give me a power. Mulk here doesn't just mean a kingdom, it means the power, the mulukiyya, the kingdom or the control that no one after me will have. So Allah says, because of his dua, we gave him the power of the wind. فَسَخَّرْنَا لَهُ الرِّيحَ. Right? تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِ رُخَانِ حَيْثُ أَصَابَ. وَالشَّيَاطِينَ. We gave him the power of the shayateen. And in other verses, we gave him the power to speak to animals. So the animals, وَحُشِرَ لِسُلَيْمَانَ جُنُودُهُ مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ وَالطَّيْرِ. And all of the armies of Suleiman, from the jinn, and the ints, and the birds, all of these are armies of Suleiman. So Suleiman was given the power to control the jinn. Okay, and even the animals and the wind. It is said that after Suleiman died, or according to one opinion, even while he was alive, the shayateen claimed to have unlocked his power. What was the power according to the shayateen? The shayateen said, Suleiman knows black magic. So he's controlling the jinn through sihr, through black magic. Then Allah defends Suleiman. وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانَ. Suleiman did not commit kufr. وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا. Rather, it was the shayateen who committed kufr. Now the verse is very difficult to understand without context. The story goes as follows. It is said that during the time of Suleiman, that somehow they managed to catch him at a time of neglect or whatever, and they started slandering and spreading rumors about him, so that people lose respect for Suleiman. And of the things that they said was that Suleiman is a magician, and that he controls the jinn through sihr. And Allah says some of the modern Yahud believe this as well. And they're, instead of following the Quran, they're following the shayateen. Then Allah defends Suleiman. Suleiman was not a kafir. وَمَا كَفَرَ Suleiman. This shows us that practicing magic makes you a kafir. Because the jinns accused Suleiman of being a magician, not of being a kafir. And Allah defended Suleiman by saying, he didn't say Suleiman was not a magician. Rather, Allah said Suleiman did not commit kufr. And from this, the scholars have derived that practicing magic is disbelief in Allah. It was the shayateen who committed kufr. How did they commit kufr? يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرِ. They were the ones teaching mankind sihr. Suleiman did not control the jinns through magic. How did Suleiman control the jinns? Allah gave him the power. Allah subjugated the jinn, not magic. I'm